Hey everybody, this is Nick. I wanted to show you one of my very favorite things to do in PowerPoint, that is making report covers and designing report covers inside of PowerPoint. It's more than just PowerPoint slides, like presentation slides that are at a widescreen orientation. You can do this with traditional report orientations as well, like this 8.5 by 11. And so I wanted to kind of just take you through some of the nuts and bolts of how I think about designing a cover page and hope that you can do your own. This is going to be a really simple one, but it's going to give you a few little tips and tricks that I hope you can take with you in your journey when you design your own cover pages. So I'm going to actually go over here to this blank slide right here, and I have a photo of that first one because we're just going to kind of use that one as our inspiration. We're going to kind of try to copy that one as we go. But the first thing that you need to do if you're doing a report like this is remember you need to change the orientation of your slide. So if you open PowerPoint, you're going to be in that 16 by 9 widescreen orientation. In order to change the orientation of your slide, just go up to the Design tab, go all the way over here to the right side, go under Slide Size, and then click on Custom Slide Size. And now there, you can go ahead and you can click on the letter 8.5 by 11. Make sure to go ahead and type in 8.5 by 11 inches in those in the height and width box, and then go ahead and make sure that portrait landscape portrait orientation is selected, and you'll get a nice page like this. And the first thing with the cover pages, we want to go ahead and create a nice background. Now you can go ahead and update the background of your slide by clicking on the background of your slide. The Format Background tab pops up. If that Format Background menu is not there, go ahead and right click on the slide and click on Format Background. Now you can go ahead and it's filled right now with just white, but you could click on the color dropdown and fill it with any other color that you wanted to. And I'm going to go ahead and fill it with a nice blue. Now this is a nice solid color, but if you want a little bit of extra visual engagement or some depth, you might want to consider a gradient. So go ahead, instead of solid fill, click on gradient fill. And now I've already been playing with some gradients, so it automatically popped up with this one. But you'll probably have one that looks a little bit more like this. It'll have like 4 gradient stops in it, and maybe it'll look really, really light on one end or you know, something. You can go ahead and just kind of play with it like this. But what I like to do is just do a nice simple gradient from like top to bottom, make it lighter to darker. So let's just go ahead and make sure, in order to get any of these gradient stops off the screen, you just have to drag them off to get rid of them. And now what I like to do is make sure that the type is set to linear, and then the direction is going to be on the top right here. Now I'm going to go ahead on my left side, the top side, I'm going to click in either a lighter or a darker shade, and the bottom I'll do a lighter or darker shade, whatever the opposite is there. So I'm going to go ahead and actually change this one. I'm going to make this one a little bit lighter on the top and a little bit darker there on the bottom. So it's going to be one of these colors on the same palette, but you can see that looks like a really nice kind of a nice visual background with a little bit of depth. Now the other thing that we're going to need is we're going to have like some space for a logo. So I like to do that with a nice rectangle. So we're going to insert a rectangle shape, and I'm just going to go ahead and put that right on the bottom, and I'm going to fill it with white, and I'm just going to say no line to that. So it's a nice shape right on top. If you had a logo image, you can put that in there. I'm just going to go ahead and insert a little icon, and that will be our logo for the day. Let's say our logo is like acorn. This acorn. And there's going to be my space for my logo. But you'll put any, sometimes you might have several logos, or you might have another sort of department name that you might want to do there. I'll just go ahead and change this little graphic to gray. So that's going to be my space for a logo. You can play with sort of the center alignment or the left alignment there. I like that pretty good. Now the other thing is I have that nice little rectangular line shape kind of going around that kind of frames the entire thing, the entire image. So I'm actually just going to use a nice box for that as well. So I'm going to go ahead and click on a rectangle. I'm going to drag it so that it's the spacing that I want. And what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to select the no fill so that there's nothing in the middle, and the line, the outline, I'm going to make it white. So we're going to do like that. I'm going to drag this up here. Let's go ahead and center this. Alignment center. And now you can't see those white lines because the background of the rectangle here is white, but if I wanted to send that into the background layer, I could just right click it and say send to back. And now I have that. Now in order to get that nice little date, sort of the date box right here, I went up and had and inserted a text box or a rectangle right here, and I just strategically placed it right there. I also am going to fill that with white and say no line. And with any shape like this, you can go ahead and start typing into it. So I'm going to go ahead and type in November 2024, and I'm going to have to update some of that text. You can see it's already white text right here, but I can update the text color like this, and I'm just going to make it nice and bold. Maybe the alignment there is set to the right. All right, I think that looks pretty nice. If I wanted it to be blue or if I wanted it to be black, I could also do it like that. And maybe just update the size of the text box just a little bit there. And now I'm going to go ahead and insert a text box for my title. And that's just going to be guest satisfaction evaluation report. And I'm going to change this text so that it's white. I'm going to update it to the Aptos Black. It's a nice big chunky font. And I'm going to increase the font size so that it spans a pretty good amount of the width of the report. And then if I wanted another text box for my author, my byline, I'm just going to go ahead and duplicate this text box. I pushed Control D to duplicate that. And I'm just going to go ahead and update the text. This is going to be just regular Aptos, and I'm going to make the font way smaller, probably down to 24. And I'm just going to say prepared by Nick Fisher. I could go ahead and update this if I wanted to, maybe a little bit smaller or maybe a little bit bigger, however you kind of like that. Let's go ahead and just align both of these to the left. Use your alignment tools to the left. That looks pretty nice. Now you can see, I'm going to go back to my other side. I actually downloaded this. This was an image of silhouettes that I thought was kind of cool. So I'm going to push Control C and copy that. But you can go up to the Insert tab. You can search online for silhouette images or either just silhouette images, PNGs, or SVGs, the SVG documents. The SVG images will let you update the colors and things like that. I'm going to put Control V to paste, and then I'm just going to put that here, but you can see it's on the top layer, so I want to actually put it to the back. So I'm going to send that to the back, and now I have a really kind of interesting sort of title there, and I'm going to go ahead and just delete that. Now the thing is, if I was creating my report in PowerPoint, that would be great. I could keep on going down, I could add new slides, and I could create my report like this. But if I wanted this report design, this cover design, to be into a Word report, all I would have to do is save this slide as an image. And so to do that, you can click on the File tab right here, click on Save As, and then you're going to browse to wherever you want to save the image. Under the file type, you're going to go down to either a JPEG, a PNG, or an SVG right here, Scalable Vector Graphic. I recommend that you do PNG and Scalable Vector Graphic. They might be a little bit larger. The PNG will be a little bit larger in size, but it might be a little bit more clear, so you want to keep that in mind. But the other option that you can do, without really losing too much clarity, because this image is already 8.5 by 11, over here in the slide sorter menu right here on the left, I'm just going to push Control C. I'm going to copy that, and then I'm going to head over to my Word document right here. This is just my blank Word document. I'm going to do Control V to paste, and that pastes the entire slide into my Word document. Now you can see it makes it smaller than the page. So what I need to do is on the little wrap, the layout options skill right here, instead of inline, I'm going to say with text wrapping right here, and then I'm going to go up to the graphic format tab, and under height, I'm going to change that dimension to 11, and width, I'm going to change that to 8.5. And it looks like it already did because it was proportional, but you can see it's not quite centered in the middle of the page. So I'm going to use my alignment tools right here to click on middle. And now I have a beautiful cover image right inside of Word. I didn't have to mess with anything, any shapes or text boxes inside of Word. I was able to just paste that entire image into the first page of my Word document, and that is my nice Word report. So I hope you got a couple tips from this little cover page makeover. I'm going to go ahead and put a link to download a lot of my different cover page templates from my Gumroad shop. It'll be a $15 download. I hope you go ahead and take that. If you learned a few new things here from this video, go ahead and comment below. Let me know how you used it. And go ahead and like the video, and of course the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. Had a great time making this for you. I love making cover pages in PowerPoint. I hope you do too, and I can't wait to see you all next time.